We are a loving religious community where you can grow spiritually and help build a more just and joyful world. To learn more about the many ways our congregation pursues this growth of our souls, please speak to someone at the welcome desk, to one of the ministers or other congregational leaders, or go onto our website at uucsr.org. We have a practice of worship in this room that the music that is presented here is not a performance, but a spiritual offering. And so we have a tradition of not applauding during the service. That being the case, I'm going to declare this an applause-full and free space for the next few minutes. Someone visiting once asked me, "Is the music always like this?" And I had to say, yes, yes, yes. The tremendous offerings that we hear each week from our choir, our soloists, our pianists, and other instrumentalists is of a very high quality, musically and spiritually, each and every week. And I would like to invite a little manual thanks for our choir and friends. Will you join me? Now, Music Sunday is a particularly special time, and we are so grateful for our orchestra at Shelter Rock that joins us today. We want to say thank you to you, too. Music Sunday is a tradition in many Unitarian Universalist congregations, and in this congregation, it goes way back to our earliest years, both in Port Washington and later our home in Plandome. For the past 25 years, count them, Music Sunday, including with many of you who've been with us for a long time, has been led by our music director and today's conductor, Stephen Michael Smith. I cannot express fully the gratitude and admiration the ministerial team has for our partnership with and the leadership of Stephen Michael Smith. And just to put a little icing on it all, we invite you all into the social hall, not only for lunch with us, but we're going to be having a big old carrot cake to honor 25 years of SMS. If you are a guest today, please, you may pick up a ticket for a free lunch at the welcome desk. So welcome all. We begin by lighting this chalice, a symbol of our faith. Then our musical offering will begin, and then at the end, when the chalice is extinguished, I will again welcome your applause. Darest thou now, O soul, walk out with me toward the unknown region, where neither ground is for feet, nor any path to follow. Attend this flame. and say together our words of affirmation. Do we have love as the spirit of this church? There we are. Love is the doctrine of this congregation. The quest for truth is its sacrament, and service is its prayer. To dwell together in peace, to seek knowledge in freedom, to serve human need. This do we affirm and covenant with each other. And shall we sing?
From all that's well.
Music.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Each Sunday, we take a special collection which extends our vision of beloved community by supporting work in the world which addresses human needs. This month, our offering provides support for UUCSR's Edward Miller Memorial Music Scholarship Fund. Named for a former UUCSR music director, the fund provides direct financial assistance to graduating high school music students in Nassau County who have demonstrated strong interest in music. We started this fund in 2004, and since that time we've given multiple scholarships every year. We invite you to contribute to the scholarship fund this year because we usually do an annual fundraising event, and we were unable to do it because of problems with scheduling. So this year we're asking people to help us so that we can continue the funds through this year. I can tell you, every dollar you contribute goes into the pocket of the students. There are no administrative fees. It's a direct pass-through from what you give to those music students. And you can give several ways. You see it on the screen. You can visit our website at UUCSR.org, or you can go to PayPal and send to donate@UUCSR.org. There is a collection box in the lobby. There's also a poster in the lobby that shows you that features the various winners over the years, and I hope you'll check that out. You also can actually pay by check and mail it to UUCSR's financial office and enter April Worship in that memo line. So if you're able to be generous, again, that is for our Music Scholarship Fund. Margaret Bonds. She was born in 1913. Her father was a doctor. Her mother was a music director at a local church. She was surrounded by music. She showed very great promise at a very young age. She studied with Florence Price. I don't know if you all know that. Kind of interesting. I didn't say she was born in Chicago, did I? She was in Chicago. She went on to Northwestern University, where she got a master's, both actually undergraduate and a master's. And it was a nightmare. She writes about it. She was allowed into Northwestern, but she was not allowed to use any of the facilities. She could not live on campus. She couldn't go to any social events. But she did graduate. She felt so constricted in Chicago, she came to New York. She went to Juilliard, studied at Juilliard, got a degree. And as most musicians who were really active and striving, she went to Paris to study with Nadia Boulanger. But Nadia Boulanger said that there was nothing she could teach her. You interpret that the way you want to interpret that. Born in, I said, 1913. In 1933, she was the first African-American soloist with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. A year later, she premiered Florence Price's Piano Concerto with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. She taught privately. She taught in institutions. She taught Ned Rorem, with whom she was friends for the rest of her life. She arranged charts for lots of the big bands. She made arrangements for Leontine Price. She was in the center of the music world in New York City. She was best friends with Langston Hughes. How many of you have heard of Florence Price before the last 5 years? Totally unrecognized. A complete unheard voice, unrecognized voice. One reason we're doing, I realize it's not Christmas, I do get that, but one reason we're doing this piece today is she wrote this in the mid-50s. I believe the first time it was performed was in 1954, but I can't find documentation about how it was performed. And why I say that is she did write it with the piano reduction, or the piano part first, and then there were several iterations, so we can find out, of the orchestrations. This is the full orchestration. We do know that in 1960, I mean, we can't even find information about her. This is what's so galling. In 1960, we know that there was a Christmas special, and they featured this Ballad of the Brown King. But I can't find out, and if any of you want to do research, I'd be fascinated, because I've been trying to figure this all out. I'm not sure it was with the orchestration. Now, luckily, in the last few years, we're starting to recognize some of these great musicians and artists and people in African-American descent that were really central in all sorts of disciplines, and music is included. And that's really a joy and really wonderful to be able to do. There have been, I know, 3 performances of this piece in New York in the last few years. But all the performances, from what I can find out, were done with a new reorchestration and a smaller orchestration by Malcolm Merriweather, who's an extraordinary conductor and musician, just named head of the department, I think, at Queens College out here. Brooklyn College? Brooklyn College. He's also the chorus master at the Philharmonic. He has a big chorus in New York, and people are doing his orchestration. And I've been in touch with him. My point being, I can't find any time when the original orchestration was done. I'm not sure that Margaret Bonds even heard her orchestration of this piece. Now, Wikipedia, the great compendium of misinformation, says that the parts for the full orchestration aren't available. Well, they are available because we're playing it today, but I can tell you that it's only recently become available. And it also says that there has never been a recording with the complete orchestration, and that I can believe. So we're breaking grounds in many ways here, but the important thing is we're getting the music from this extraordinary musician into the air, and I'm very appreciative of Shelter Rock's support for, and the choir support and the orchestra for making this happen. So one of our chorus members put on Facebook that this was a Long Island premiere. She got a little kickback, but we corrected that. So I'm not going to claim what this is today, but I can tell you, from my point of view, this might be the first time we've heard the complete orchestration. It might be the third time it's ever been done. Not only is it significant historically, but I think this is a wonderful piece. And I just want to say, for me, from my perspective, I love this piece because the way she uses the orchestra. And when we talk about orchestration, it's how we take the music and then, in a sense, you can think, divvy it up among all the different sounds in the orchestra. So you're going to hear sounds that are somewhat unique. Also, she was a very, very accomplished classical musician. But she also embraced other styles. So you're going to hear almost like a calypso style in here. You're going to hear a gospel-y style. You're going to hear a jazz style, all infused in this style that I would just say is Margaret Bonds' style. So again, as David said, this is a worship service. So I'd ask you, you're going to want to applaud because we have some extraordinary soloist singing. But just relax and just take it in. At the very end, after it's all done, we can recognize the talent, but I urge you just to soak in the sounds of, to start with, the Ballad of the Brown King by Margaret Bonds. And the Brown King was Balthazar, one of the three kings who came to the Nativity. What's happening. If that happens, don't worry, just stay in place, and we have a generator that kicks in, so you're safe, and it'll just take a while for us to reboot. So it's happened twice.
One was a broken father. Egyptian king. From the land where the sun shines bright, I don't know.
Oh,
kiss the score because I had a malfunction in my iPad on the other piece. So 25 years ago, one of the first pieces I did with the choir was Toward the Unknown Region. And throughout my career, when I started with choral groups, I've often done it in the first concert because I think it's appropriate. We all get together, get to know each other. We have no idea where we're going. So here, 25 years later, I'm saying to you, we still don't know where we're going, and we don't know what the future will hold, but at least we're doing it together.
Thank you.
Please join us for some celebratory cake.
Leave him on the chair.